Hello, my name is Daniel Gomes, and I was one of the editors of the book entitled The Past Web, Exploring Web Archives. I believe that this book can be useful to support web archiving activities. Julia Massenet organized the first web archiving workshops, and the first publication of my career was in one of them. It was on the third workshop on web archives in 2003. Julia Massenet also edited the first book on web archiving in 2006. That's one reason why he is known to be the father of web archiving in Europe. The web archiving book was very useful to continue my research since 2003, until I started the Portuguese Web Archive project in 2007. It was during the TPDL conference in 2018 where we organized a tutorial about how to research the past web using web archives, that Springer invited me to write a new book on web archiving. Elena Demidova, Jane Winters, and Thomas Risse were also at TPDL. And during a coffee break, I asked if they would like to help me editing the new book. They said yes. We gathered contributions from 40 authors from 12 countries around the world. After 4 years, the book was published in July of 2021. The main objective of the book is to support web archiving activities by raising awareness about the importance of web archiving, creating a new education resource to train new web archivists, disseminating services offered by web archives, and to share inspiring research that used web archives. But besides web archivists, this book aims to also reach professors to teach about web preservation, researchers to study the past through the web, computer scientists to develop new applications to explore historical web data, information professionals to also preserve online information, and citizens so that they can access the past information as easily as they can access the current information. The book is divided in 6 parts. Part 1, entitled The Era of Information Abundance and Memory Scarcity, motivates to the need of preserving the web. Part 2 presents several approaches followed by web archives to collect information from the web to be preserved. On each turn, Part 3 presents methods to access the historical web data preserved by web archives. Part 4 shares inspiring use cases of research done using web archives. And Part 5 discusses the role of web archives as infrastructures to develop innovative services. Finally, Part 6, that was written in collaboration with Julien Massenet, who edited the 2006 book, Web Archiving, shares the main lessons learned and recommendations for the future of web archiving. An innovation introduced on the past web book was that all the cited URLs on the book were web archived. It is interesting to notice that despite the book was published less than 1 year ago, some of its precious citations to online information are no longer available on the web. But fortunately, they can still be accessed on Arquivo.pt because they were web archived. The initial results are promising. The past web book was downloaded 20,000 times in less than 1 year, while its predecessor, web archiving, was downloaded 11,000 times in 16 years. The past web book was written to support web archiving, so please disseminate it among your communities. There is a free preprint version available in open access at archive.pt/book. Thank you for your attention.